Anyway, same though. I'm going to answer your prayer.
Yes.
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter number 3 and verses number 16.
Yes.
And it reads, do you not know?
Do you not know
that you are the temple?
That you seated on that chair, you are the temple of God.
Some of you are not even,
he's going to show us here the temple of God.
I'm not going to show you. You are the temple of God.
Yeah.
So when I look at you, oh my God, that's why the Bible says when the two gather in one room, when there are two or three are gathered, I am in the midst.
Because if you gather with your brother and you are praying in your house, which means two temples are praying,
because where you are, in your body,
you are projecting Jesus.
I can see you people.
You want to face Jerusalem? You are looking at this window because I'm looking at it. Shana, come on. Listen to this.
Listen to this.
Leave us, come on.
And it reads,
tell them about the spiritual portal.
The spiritual portal.
If you're praying for 20, some of you, maybe you are fasting. You are praying. Look why you are not going to come on. Listen to me. You're wasting your time. I want to show you the quickest way on how God can answer your prayer.
Amen.
This temple, maybe it's there. Now it is a museum. I cannot face it and pray now.
Do you not know, my brother, where you are?
Do you not know, my sister, where you are?
Seated on that chair.
Like you, seated there. You are the temple of God.
Yes, there is.
1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses number 16 and 17.
Yes.
It says, do you not know?
Maybe you don't know. We are telling you now.
That you are the temple of God.
Is it saying that the pastor is the temple of God?
No.
Who?
Me.
Who? Lift up your hand and be with confidence. Who?
I.
Say I.
I.
Who? You are who?
The temple of God.
You are who?
The temple of God.
The Bible says, the day that you gave your life to Jesus, he entered into you. And now, the Bible says, I am knocking at the door. If anyone shall hear my voice, I shall enter. He shall dine with me, and I shall dine with him. Now you are no longer single. You are now married to Jesus. This is the reason why last time I told you about offer. I talked about offering. I talked about the offer that you bring when you come to church. And because Jesus is the husband, you offer and he gives you the ring. It becomes the offering that we give in church. Now I'm telling you this. God is living in you by the name of Jesus Christ, the man Jesus. As he's living in you, you are no longer alone, but he's with you.
Yes.
This is the reason why when Daniel prayed, he was with God. And God, the lions could not eat him.
Yes.
The den of lions might not be there today, but there is a den of lions that is God in poverty fighting people.
Yes.
The Bible says, do you not know that you are the temple of God?
Yeah.
Who is the temple of God?
Me.
Your neighbor.
Myself.
Who is the temple of God?
Your neighbor.
If you are looking for God, if you look at your neighbor, you are looking at God. Because the Bible says, God created man in the image of God. Look at that, she's laughing. You are looking at God. Read again, Pastor.
Do you not know?
I'm about to conclude, I'm not going to take time.
That you are the temple of God.
Do you not know? It's a question, do you not know?
That you are the temple of God.
And that the Spirit of God.
That not only you are accommodating Jesus, but also is what?
The Spirit of God.
Where is the Spirit?
Dwells in you.
Can I show you how to face the temple?
Yes.
Can I show you how to face the temple?
Yes.
My speech is excited. Can I show you how to face the temple?
Yes.
I'm very excited. Can I show you how to face the temple?
Yes.
All right, come study. How are we going to look at you? Come study. Face each other.
First each other. Okay?
Okay, what do we do there?
Yes. First each other. I'm excited.
Are you excited?
Yes, ma'am. Very much.
Yeah, we praise you a lot.
The Bible talks about the Ark of the Covenant. If you take the picture of the Ark of the Covenant, there are two angels that are on the cover, on the lid there. They are facing each other and their wings are flipping forward. Is that correct?
Yes.
So, my baby, I'm like, so, I'm like, so. So, this side, can you do like your hands like this? That's how the Ark of the lid on the Ark of the Covenant is. There are two angels there. It's like they are leaning down and their wings are facing each other. This is the reason why in the book of Matthew, chapter number 16, the Bible says, if the two of you, because you are temples, face each other, you are looking at the temple, you need to look at the other temple. And you need to look at the other temple. And when you pray in my name, whatsoever you want, whatsoever she wants, it shall be given unto you.
Yeah. The book of Matthew, chapter number 18.
Yes.
Verses number 19.
Yes, he said what he says.
And it says, Again I say to you.
Again I say to you
that if the two of you agree on earth.
You agree on where?
Earth.
Because you are a temple and you are also a what?
Temple.
So when you agree, temple plus temple, you agree together. What are you facing now? What are you facing? So that Solomon says, when you pray in your house, face the temple, and wheresoever you face the temple, God shall answer your prayer.
Yeah. Who is the temple of God?
I am the temple of God.
You are the temple of God.
Yes.
So, brother, keep looking. You're looking for Jerusalem.
Please again, Pastor. Again I say to you that if the two of you
agree on earth
concerning anything,
a plane, school fees, motor vehicle, a motorbike, a bicycle, marriage, plot, I want to go to Australia. If you agree concerning anything on earth, what will happen?
That they ask. It will be done.
For them.
By my Father in heaven.
Amen.
Why is it going to be done? Because you're facing the temple.
Amen.
Tell me about the spiritual point.
Can
I tell you a secret?
Yes.
When I want to do something for this church, when I'm praying for God, I'm believing God for something, what I do is I tell my wife,
temple of God, come here. Face the temple. Let us pray. Before the end of this month, we shall buy another show. And automatically it comes. Because someone says, when you pray, you face the temple. When I look at you, I am looking at the temple. You are the temple of God. I don't need to look for that temple that is in Jerusalem. When I look at a brother in this room, I look at who you are, the temple of God. You are the temple of God. I don't need to look for that temple in Jerusalem. When I look at you, where you are, I see the temple of God. Now look at your neighbor, tell them you are the temple of God.
But I don't know where they go to Jerusalem now. Madam,
I don't know.
But I understand the word of God. And the word of God shall make you rich.
This is why I tell people, I am not looking for millionaires. When I look at you, I look
I am the temple of God. Excellent. Look at the neighbor, tell them, you are the temple of God.
You are the temple of God.
Don't mind the way they are looking at you. Just tell them you are the temple of God.
You are the temple of God.
That's why when the two of us agree, the Bible says in heaven, the angels sing Hosanna, hallelujah. Do you know what they do when they sing? They kneel down, look at each other, and begin to sing holy. When you want to sing, even the way you sing in this church, when you are singing, you need somebody to back you. The backing is coming from somebody who is facing you. The opposite where you are. When you sing in church, there will be soprano, 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 soprano. We sing one voice, but you're facing each other. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, I know you are in the den of lions, but God is about to get you out. Let me tell you something, child of God. There will come a time when the people that love you will accuse you. They will want to stone you to death. There will come a time when problems will come by the name of sickness. There will come a time when rejection shall be part of your journey. Yes. People begin to reject you. Yes. But sometimes you'll be possessed with a sickness that shall entice you so strong that you fail to pray. You try to get a job, you don't get the job. Today I have a formula for you. Yes. You are going to hold the hand of your neighbor. And you are going to tell them, neighbor, we are green because you are the temple of God. Yes. God, your neighbor dresses like God. This is the reason why we say take care of your body. Do not expose your body to things that are useless. Do not smoke, do not kill, because you are the temple of God. The temple of God cannot commit adultery. The temple of God cannot murder someone. I want to tell you that where you are, your hands are the temple of God. Your nose is the temple of God. And where you are right now, you carry power and authority. But when you command something, a mountain shall move to another location, because you are the temple of God. Yeah. 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 Let me tell you people, I know I'm sick, but I'm the temple of God. I know I'm sick, but I'm the temple of God. Do you not know that you are the temple of God? You can reject me today, but I'm the temple of God. The Bible says the stone that you have rejected has now become the chief cornerstone. Don't laugh at a man that is alive. You look at a man who is very sick today, walking with a stick, and you laugh at him. He's very sick today. You shall find them very healthy, strong as a horse. And they are moving because they are the temple of God. I come to tell you today, doesn't matter what you're going through. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor! Church, we can try by all means to decorate this church with our hands. Try to sweep the church. I want you to put your house in order. When I say your house, clean your life. Start living a holy life. If you used to watch pornography, clean your life because you are the temple of God. If you use your mouth to insult, stop insulting because you are the temple of God. If you are using your body for fornication, stop fornicating because you are the temple of God. If you are going to nightclubs, you are taking the church in the bar. When you are dancing in the bar, the church is dancing in the bar. It is not the beauty going to church, it is you going to the bar. When you dance in the bar, the church is dancing in the bar. Because you are the temple of God. They will send it on today. People can come to church and yet they can live another life. Pretend to love God, but they're not doing things. Oh God, you are the temple of God. Some people wonder in this room, why is it that God is not answering my prayers? Check your life. For you to be the temple of God, you have to be clean. If we can clean this church, we can clean this room. You have to clean your life as well. Because you are the temple of God. When I look at you, sir, I don't know what name they have given you, but I call you the temple of God.
Amen.
Can I talk to people here?
Amen.
How come if you are the temple of God, you are half naked when you are walking in the streets of Lusaka? How come? Shame on you. You are the temple of God. How come if you are the temple of God, you are making appointments to sleep with your boyfriend? You are the temple of God.
Let me tell you something.
A pastor who loves you,
yes,
will tell you, work out your own salvation,
yes,
with fear and trembling.
Yes.
Because Jesus is coming again. Repent when you have time. We all want to be blessed. We all want to drive beautiful cars. But it's time for you to look at your table, organize it, because Jesus can come anytime. I usually tell people in this place, you did not know that you are going to be born on a Thursday. Your mother is the one who told you we will never know the day so. And the time was so. You never chose that day. The same applies as when you are about to die. That's why I tell people, give your life to Jesus. This is the why we preach. This is what we preach here. You are the temple of God. I've seen temples who behave like something else. A temple. Drunk, failing to walk. A temple. There are no rains, but it is raining somewhere because the temple is dry. The temple. Look at the neighbor, smile at them. Look at the neighbor, smile at them. Tell them you are the temple of God.
You are the temple of God.
Some sisters, they wear Christianity when they are church. No, go home, you see how they behave. It's something else. San Jimmy's a doctor, you know, many years. My name is your own. It's my name, your child. There's Facebook there. Instagram. Look at the way you are looking so nice. Let's check your post on Facebook. And I wonder why women.
Men who understand, I wonder why. Any woman who wants to post something, I wonder why.
Do you not know that you are the temple?
Well,
starting so well and ending well. I would rather start.